welcome to Fusion. We're going to get started with some songs here. Dear God, I just want to ask that you be with us this morning. Thank you for this Sabbath that we can come and worship and praise your name. And please just come into this place this morning and help us to just feel a little bit of you. Amen.
Well, I know this life.
My fault, okay. It's still morning. Some of us haven't woke up yet. How are you all doing this morning? You're quiet out there. We have a few that are awake. Let's go ahead and stand for this next song.
Grandeur earth is quaked before, moved by the sound of his voice. Seas that are shaken and stirred can be calmed and broken for my regard. Through it all, my eyes are on. Thank you.
this next song is one that my dad said he usually does around Easter time. Jemi and I won't be here next week again, but so we're going to go ahead and do it next this week. Words are hard.
Yeah. Good morning, everyone. Just bow your heads with me for a quick prayer. Dear God, it's kind of overcast today. It's definitely spring weather, and a lot of us probably would have liked to just lay in bed a little bit longer this morning, but we're here because we want to feel your presence, God, and we want to worship you through song and just feel you today, God. So please be with us and help us to open our minds to what you have to share with us. In your name I pray, amen. Prayer. What are your first thoughts that you think of when you wake up in the morning? Anyone have anything they want to share? That's routine? No? Okay, well, for me, every morning when my alarm goes off, I usually set it for a little bit earlier than I think I need to get ready. But then I hit snooze like two or three times, and I'm calculating in my head, okay, I need 5 minutes for this, 10 minutes for that, 15 to 20 minutes for horses, depending on my horse and how he's acting, and 5 minutes again for that. And so I'm subtracting and figuring out what time I have to actually get out of bed. But what if our first thoughts in the morning went straight to God? And I know like that seems probably kind of difficult for a lot of us, because when we first wake up, like, we're just thinking of our day and everything that's going on. But it would be such a positive way to start your day if your first thought was like, oh, hi God, how are you? And when I was in Fiji, actually, that's like, I had several hours in the morning. I woke up at sunrise and I would have like 2 hours before we had anything to do. And so I was able to actually tune my mind to God. And here, for some reason, it's just so much more difficult. We have all of these things going on. But if we could start our day off with asking God, God, what do you want to show me today? I think that could change our entire day and our entire outlook on how that day goes. And throughout the first couple of books in the New Testament, Jesus prays a lot to the Father. He prays for strength, wisdom, guidance. He prays to be reunited with God. He prays for his disciples and followers. Pray without ceasing. Renew your hearts each day by committing yourself to Christ. Pray for the power of the Holy Spirit at every encounter, because your life depends upon it. Set your minds on heaven, not on the things of this world. Continue earnestly in prayer and stay spiritually alert. Over and over, we are told to pray. Even taught the Lord's Prayer at a young age. I remember being very young, like maybe 4 or 5 years old, whatever the earliest memories I can remember, and doing like sundown worships at my grandparents' house, and either Grandpa Morgan or Dad or an uncle would say the words and lead us in the prayer you taught us to say, and all of its grandkids would be like, oh yes, we get to actually say the words. And we just loved it. Like, I have vivid memories of that growing up. And God didn't give us prayer just to utter meaningless declarations to him. I feel like a lot of times we're taught like, have to pray before this, have to pray after this, have to pray here and there. And it's not the prayer that is the important part. It's the fact that we are speaking to our Heavenly Father. It's the fact that for the length of that prayer, we are focusing our mind on heaven and on God. And instead of speaking to a friend or loving father, we offer rehearsed speeches. And you know, a lot of times we come to God when we have all these issues, like, oh, I need to pay rent this month, or I have these bills that I need to pay, or there's this issue, someone is sick, someone is dying. And that's when we come to God. In James 5, 13 through 18, he talks about the power of prayer. He says, bring all things to the Lord in prayer. If you're sick, if you're falling on hard times, if you're happy. So it's not that we're not supposed to pray for those things, we are. But I think we often get hung up on only praying during the times that we need something, and not when we want to feel God's blessing. In John 17, Jesus spends the whole chapter praying to the Father. It's incredible to me that he came to this world knowing that he would no longer feel God's presence. He would feel what we feel, he would see what we see, he would know what we know. And yet, he did that. He separated himself from the Father to come down here. And he found the Father, though, not through some divine means of communication, because that was cut off, but he found God through the same way that he taught us to find God, through prayer, and praying the same prayers that he taught us to say. I like the simplicity of it. And I think that if we can ignore the part where we're taught to pray at all these different times and pray these prayers, and if we can just focus on the fact that we are just talking to our Heavenly Father and we are looking for that communication with Him, I think it can make a lot of difference in how we pray. I've always thought that prayer was the easy part of having a relationship with God, because all you have to do is speak the words, right? But then I actually wrote all of this out when I was in Fiji, and when I was thinking about it, I was like, wait, when was the last time I prayed? And I, like, there's times when I'll be kind of just like talking like, oh God, you know, this would be nice, or whatever, like we're just kind of talking, but to actually just have 5 minutes or 10 minutes of just prayer, I realized it had probably been several days since I had just sat down and really focused my mind on God and heaven. And so I prayed that day that God would give me a desire for Him, and that my mind would continually want to learn more, and that my heart would want to share Him with others. And I think that a lot of times He does give us opportunities throughout our day to reach out to other people, but how many times do we pass those up because we don't want to ruin the reputation of the day by doing something that might force us to look at some other thing that we maybe could ignore otherwise. You are the source of all life. As we walk in your light, we see the truth. Continue your loving kindness to those who know you and bring salvation to those who are committed to doing right. And so I think our prayer today should be, God, help us to see what you want us to see. Help us to see those opportunities and do something about it. There was a moment when we were at the resort there in Fiji, and I had seen this lady kind of throughout our couple of days there at the stay, and she was always by herself. And I first kind of noticed it a couple times. We had gone out for lunch or something. I saw her then, and then it was the night the group left, and I had gone over to get some food or something with Jordy, and the lady was there. She was eating dinner by herself, and so I actually asked one of the waitresses, like, is she here by herself? And they said, yeah. And I felt that God was telling me, go talk to her, just go make a connection. And I did not do it, and I regret it, because I'm not very good at just walking up to random people. I'm like, Michael Gary, he's very good at it. He can make connections and just start talking to people, and I don't have that. But after that moment, I prayed, or after that time passed, I started praying in the mornings when I woke up, like, God, help me to give me the strength to do what I need to do in these types of situations. And so even though it's still a work in progress, like, I haven't conquered that or anything, but I think that just focusing our mind on heaven for the first few minutes of our day and focusing our mind on God, he can open up those opportunities for us. And it's really cool to see when he does show us things. And if you hadn't prayed that prayer, maybe you would have not seen how God had worked his hand in a miracle or in something that happened. And it's just something that it's good to be aware of and to think about, and God has something that he wants to share with each of us each day. He wants to show us new things. He wants to bring something to our attention, and we can do that by focusing our first few minutes of the day on him, and even focusing throughout the day on him. But those first few minutes, I feel like, are very important for just setting the mood and the tone for the whole day. Will you bow your heads with me? Dear God, help us to feel you. Help us to focus our minds on you and to ignore the distractions of everything that tries to come in and bombard our minds with things that are not of you, God. Help us to see you, help us to feel you, and help us to know you better through focusing our minds on you. In your name I pray, amen.
Thank you.
stand for this song?
How great the chasm that lay between us. How high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. Then through the darkness your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The world is finished, the end is written. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Who could imagine so great?
Father in heaven, Jesus Christ, you sent him to earth. He is our living hope. We are absolutely nothing and lost without him. Through the precious blood that he shed for us, we are forgiven. Through his very life that lives in us, we are made ready for heaven. We are nothing without him. Help us not to forget that as we go through this week. Thank you, Jesus.